Section number two, player number 210150, Melbourne, Jack Trengove Sturt.
Regarded as one of the under-18's best leaders, South Australian captain Jack Trengove has developed into one of the country's finest young footballers, and his impressive performances in this year's under-18 championships underline just why he is so highly regarded by AFL recruiters. He took out the MVP award for his state in the under-18s and earned All-Australian honours. He also played the last half of the 09 season with the Sturt seniors and starred in their preliminary final victory over Glenelg.
And the number one draft pick for 2009, player number 210373, Melbourne, Tom Scully, Dandenong Stingrays.
As well as being a prolific ball winner, particularly in congestion, Tom Scully is a fine finisher when in range of goal.
Straightens up 30 metres out, and Tom Scully!
The dual All-Australian and Vic Metro skipper also possesses terrific hands and vision, and when in space, uses the ball extremely well. Scully's endurance is also a feature of his play, and when others are spent, the 18-year-old is invariably finishing full of steam. He won Metro's MVP in this year's under-18 championships, averaging 25 disposals and 5 clearances per game.
Congratulations, the stuff dreams are made of. What was that moment like when Andrew finally read out your name?
Yeah, obviously a very exciting moment for myself and my family. I'm pretty much speechless at the moment. Yeah, I'm really excited.
So much pressure, expectation, hype and media talk leading up to it. I bet all you want to do now is get down to Junction Oval and do some training.
Yeah, that's it. You know, the media and that was building up a bit, but, you know, it was all external, so, you know, I wasn't really worrying about it too much. But, it's good to be finally drafted and really just looking forward to getting down to the club.
Dean, you've picked up two wonderful footballers in the top 10 in Jack and Tom. How did you split them? Such a tough decision, no doubt.
We couldn't split them, unfortunately. We were required to call them out one by one. If it was up to me, I'd call them both out and come out together. So we couldn't really split them, but we've got to put them in that order, and I see them both as equals, and they're going to really contribute well to the Melbourne Football Club, and they got great character, and we look forward to them running out and playing next year.
It's moments like this that must make coaching seem like a pretty great gig.
Yeah, I've had 2 years of struggle for 2 years. So, the opportunity has arisen and we've got to make the most of it. And the players we draft today are going to be important for the future. So there's a lot of pressure on them. But from a club point of view, we look forward to next year and beyond. And we've got some really good young players here, and we're going to draft a few more tonight. And we're going to make some inroads in the next couple of years.
Well, congratulations, Tom. Join the rest of the group. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the cream of the crop, the 2009 AFL National Draft Top 10. We now hand it over to Andrew Demetriou to continue with the remainder of round one.
We'll resume the first round. Selection 11, Melbourne Football Club.
Player 210560, Jordan Gisberts, Eastern Rangers.
Selection 12.
Interesting to see the Demons, three midfielders in those first three picks. We thought maybe one and two, Scully and Trengove, but then we'd probably see maybe a taller player like a Talia type player or a Johnny Butcher as well.
Oh, that's a stop. Share it through the middle.
Melbourne.
Player number 210087, Luke Tapscott, North Adelaide.
Selection 19, Richmond.
You talk about your drama. We thought that Melbourne might take Luke Ball with pick 18. It was a Luke, but it was not Luke Ball. Round two of the 2009 NAB AFL draft is complete. Let's have a look at the way that it panned out and let our experts cast their eye over that and tell us surprises or...
Just a little bit of a few. Luke Tapscott, a bit like a Paul Chapman, so he's a powerful, medium, small forward, fantastic kick. Well, the first of the tall blokes, Max Gawn, who is the biggest bloke we've ever had to draft camp. He's a whole 207 centimetres. We thought he may have gone early, but he's gone. And Jack Fitzpatrick, Lynch, you've been interesting one you had a little bit to do with in his last couple of years.
Yeah, he had some chronic fatigue issues, and I just tried to help him there. And I mean, he's an extremely athletic, I think about the 201, 202 centimetres, extremely athletic ruckman that can go forward, so he could develop into a very good pick. There's
and Jake Melksham there in the finish. He's an Oak Park boy, not far from Essendon. He's got a 5-minute bike ride to get there.
He'll love that, won't he?
Oh, I love it. He was best on the ground in the TAC Cup Grand Final. It's really made his year and helped Essendon select him, no doubt.
Because we saw the D's there with the top two picks in Tob Scully and Jack Trengove. There was talk at different stages of the build-up about maybe make Trengove number one if it's better for him to handle it, or does that come into the psyche of the clubs? We heard Dean Bailey when they were picked actually say we'd like them to be equal number ones.
Well, in the end they have to split them, but St Kilda did it with Rewalt and Kaczynski many years ago now. But it's interesting because we heard the way he was in the interviews, Tom Scully. I mean, he's an impressive young bloke. I have no issues that he'll be able to handle it. Absolutely no problems with that. You know him really well, Lynch. I mean, he's a level-headed kid.
He's a very level-headed kid. I think he can certainly handle the focus, as he's handled the focus over the last 12 months. But I suppose that they were tossing up whether he'd played against men. And I suppose coming off the experience of Jack Watson, a lot of focus on him. He hadn't played against men before. So Trengove had certainly done that. But Scully's well and truly equipped to handle it both on and off the field.
Melbourne, well, they've had a swag of good players picked there, haven't they?
Win. Yeah. Scully and Trengrove, a couple of stars, another gun midfielder in Gisbert's. Tapscott's a good player. Gawn's a ruckman, which they desperately need, and they've gone Fitzpatrick. Lynchy, I think he's probably more of a forward that can potentially play Russ than a ruckman.
He's certainly very athletic, but how long will it be till we see those two or three names line up in the midfield for Melbourne?
Your former teammate, Brad Scott.